Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, today we are going to see initial conditions for inductor and capacitor. We know that these are very important elements for any electrical circuit, and we will see what exactly happens to them or how they react when either we switch on or switch off a circuit, which is called as a transition. So let us take example of an inductor. Suppose I have an inductor to which I am applying some voltage V of t, voltage which is function of time. Suppose I am applying a DC voltage which is called as V, and like this is time t equal to 0, this is time which is going to increase as t equal to infinity. So how this inductor reacts? Now, we all know that voltage across inductor is called as V equal to L di by dt. Now, as voltage is DC voltage, similarly, the current which will result because of this will also be a DC current. So, that current will also be like this. This is t equal to 0. This all is t greater than 0. So voltage across inductor, so I will call as VL, is equal to magnitude wise L di by dt. In short, this means that for any change in current, there exists a voltage or EMF across this inductor. This formula comes from Faraday's law. We will not go into details of it. Now what exactly happens? Now see, suppose initially there is no voltage applied. So how it will behave? Accordingly, from this formula, VL equal to L di by dt, we will calculate I, so V into dt will become L into di. So if you integrate both sides, first we will take L here, so it will become V by L into dt equal to di. And if you solve this, if we integrate both sides, we will get 1 by L V into dt is equal to I of t. So this is how we get current for inductor. We have already got voltage for inductor from this formula. So voltage is L di by dt. By solving this formula, we get current for inductor, which is 1 by L V into dt, plus there is something called as I of 0, which is called as constant of integration, which comes from initial conditions, which we will study. Similarly, for capacitor, so we will see capacitor now. We are going to apply a voltage like this, which will result in current. You can calculate same way, DC current. Now for capacitor, we have this formula that current across capacitor is equal to C into dV by dt. This comes from the basic formula that current is equal to dq by dt, and this q is nothing but equal to cv. So if you substitute it here, it will be c into dv by dt. And so again, from this formula, so this is one formula, we can derive another formula by solving this right hand side. So what I will do, from this formula, I through the capacitor is equal to c dv by dt, it is ic into dt equal to c into dv. Again, if you integrate both sides, you can take this c here, so it becomes 1 by c ic into dt plus v of 0 is equal to v. Where again, this v of 0 is a constant of integration which comes from initial condition that time t equal to 0. Now we will see what are initial conditions. Initial conditions are nothing but when circuit is switched on or off. So for example, if I have a circuit, through which voltage V is applied, current is I. Now at t equal to 0, I am going to close this circuit. So in short, there will be an instant which will be just before t equal to 0. So at t equal to 0, switch is closed. So at t equal to 0 minus, it is called as an instant, which is just before circuit is closed. And similarly, t equal to 0 plus, it is just after circuit is closed. Mainly, these are called as initial conditions, just before circuit is closed and just after circuit is closed. There is something called as final condition. So this was all about initial condition. Our final condition is called as t equal to plus infinity. This can be called as final condition. Now what we will do, we will see how inductor solely behaves at initial condition. So we'll take example of inductor. Suppose we have inductor to which I have applied voltage V. At time t equal to 0, switch will be closed. Switch is closed. Now see, before switch is closed, current through the circuit is 0. That means no current is flowing through this inductor. Now inductor has this formula, VL equal to L into DI by DT. Inductor has one property that it doesn't accept any change in current, any abrupt change in current. When time t is 0 minus, so at t equal to 0 minus, the current through this circuit, which we can call as I of 0 minus, is equal to 0. As inductor doesn't accept any change, so even at t equal to 0 plus, the current I 0 plus is also 0 amperes. This is one way. There is one more way to understand this, that you can see that di by dt is nothing but current. So we will, if you draw the diagram of current, this is I, this is how it behaves with time, this is t equal to 0. So just after t equal to 0, the current is increasing with infinite slope. See, this arrow indicates that from this position to this position, it requires infinite slope. So di by dt becomes infinity. For di by dt to become infinity, you will need voltage equal to infinity. And infinite voltage is nothing but open circuit. So current being equal to 0 at 0 plus, or voltage being equal to infinity, indicates that it is open circuit. So we can have a conclusion that inductor at t equal to 0 plus behaves as open circuit. Now we will see how capacitor behaves. So for capacitor, we'll do the same thing. There is a switch which will be applied. This is IC. Now current through capacitor IC is equal to C into dV by dt. This V is nothing but DC. So if you draw the graph of this voltage initially at t equal to 0, or you can say at t equal to 0 minus, this V is 0. So when voltage across this capacitor is 0, it must behave as short circuit. One more way to see this is at t equal to 0 minus, voltage is 0. So at t equal to 0 plus, again, a capacitor doesn't accept any abrupt change in voltage. So it continues to be in its own state. So again at t equal to 0, the voltage across capacitor is also 0, so it is short circuit. It continues its state. One more way to learn this is, from t equal to 0 to t equal to 0 plus, when it switches its amplitude, you can see at t equal to 0, it is 0 amplitude. At t equal to 0 plus, which is just after t equal to 0, it has some finite value. But for this to occur, that means to occur this transition, which is along the arrow, you need infinite slope of dV by dt. Now what is slope? Slope is, we all know that, y2 minus y1 upon x2 minus x1. So for this graph, you can see that x is same. If you take this point, if you see here, this point, suppose it is 0, 0, and this point has x equal to 0, and suppose it has y equal to y2. So if you calculate slope for these two points, slope will be y2 minus 0 upon 0 minus 0. So almost obviously it will be infinity. And when this slope becomes infinity, that will require current to be infinity. So infinite current means huge current, and that indicates that it is a short circuit. This is also one more way. So a capacitor at t equal to 0 plus behaves as short circuit. So to summarize all the initial conditions, let us take example of inductor and capacitor. So we have an inductor with no current initially. So this is the first one, and this is at time t equal to 0 plus. We have just seen that at time t equal to 0 plus, it behaves as open circuit, because initially there was no current and inductor doesn't accept any current or any change in current, in fact. So it behaves as open circuit, because current equal to 0 means always open circuit. Now if the same inductor is having current equal to I0, so if current I0 passes through inductor initially, that is at t equal to 0 minus, so at even at t equal to 0 minus, I0 passes through inductor. In such case, inductor will simply can be replaced by a current source with value I0, because that was its initial state. Such numericals and cases will come in when we solve problems. Third was the capacitor with voltage equal to 0, initial voltage. So at that time, at t equal to 0 minus, this was the capacitor. This was all about inductor. At t equal to 0 minus, the voltage across capacitor was 0. And so the capacitor was said to be short circuited. Even at t equal to 0 plus, it was short circuited, because it also doesn't accept any change in voltage. And the fourth one, which I will draw on the next page, and that is a capacitor with voltage, you can say V0 plus minus. So if initially capacitor is charged with a value V0 at t equal to 0 plus, this capacitor can be replaced by a voltage source whose value is V0, because this was its initial voltage. And capacitor formula, we all know that the capacitor formula is I equal to C into dV by dt. So any change in voltage will not be accepted. So this will be simply V0. If initial voltage is V0, that voltage will be taken as a voltage source. Now, there is something called as final condition, and final condition means t equal to infinity. Now final condition can also be called as steady state condition. Now we all know that inductor formula VL equal to L di by dt. When you have a DC voltage and DC current, you have this kind of current with respect to time. This is current. So for this current, see, it is steady. So di by dt will become 0, and voltage across inductor will become 0. So it will behave as short circuit. So at t equal to infinity or at final condition, inductor behaves as short circuit. If you apply the same logic to capacitor, if you apply the logic to an inductor through which current I0 is passing, then you have to write it like this. It behaves as short circuit, but with current source I0. For capacitor, which behaves as short circuit at t equal to 0 plus. See, we all know that the current through this capacitor is equal to C into dV by dt. So when voltage at t greater than 0, and as time increases, it becomes infinity. So if this is the graph for voltage, there is no change in voltage. You can see it is steady. So if voltage is not changing, current also will become 0, because dV by dt will be 0. So current equal to 0 means it will behave as open circuit. So exactly reverse happens. At t equal to 0 plus, inductor is open circuit, but at t equal to infinity, it behaves as short circuit. Capacitor behaves as short circuit at t equal to 0 plus, but at t equal to infinity, it behaves as open circuit. Now at t equal to infinity, this capacitor, which was initially charged with potential V0, we have just seen in last page that it behaves as open circuit. Now, because it has voltage V0 now, so it will behave as voltage V0 in series with open circuit. So this is all about initial and final conditions. So again, to summarize, inductor at t equal to 0 plus open circuit, t equal to infinity short circuit. Inductor with current value I0 At t equal to 0 plus, it behaves as current source I0. At t equal to infinity, that current source I0 is in parallel with a short circuit capacitor. At t equal to 0 plus, it behaves as short circuit. At t equal to infinity, it behaves as open circuit. And a capacitor, which is initially charged with value V0. At t equal to 0 plus, it behaves as a voltage source of value V0. And at t equal to infinity, it behaves as voltage source whose value is V0 and open circuit. This is all about initial conditions of inductors and capacitors. All these formulas will be required in numerator. So, thank you very much for watching this video. Stay tuned with eKida. Please subscribe to eKida.